So where are we?
Oh, well, we're in Warrens, Wisconsin, Monroe County, Lincoln Township. My grandfather showed up here four generations ago, about 1850 to 1875. I'm the fourth generation, well, maybe even fifth. And this barn right here that's behind us was built in 1902. So we're looking at about 114 years old. My grandfather grew apples. My dad, he didn't care about apples. He milked cows. And when I come back out of the service, I started in growing produce, growing apples. I started planting apples in 1973 at about 500 a year. And we've got about between 5,000 and 6,000 trees now at about 30 acres.
All right. What kind of apples?
Well, we've got several varieties, about a dozen. McIntosh and Cortland, which are well known in this area. We got one of our main ones is Regent. That's very much similar to Honeycrisp, which is right here to my right. They are an apple that was grown in, by seed in the University of Minnesota, along with Honeycrisp, the same thing was developed in Minnesota.
All right. And what kind of apples is the best for you, you think?
Oh, well, that depends on what you're going to do with them. Are you going to eat them? Well, Honeycrisp and Regent would be very much similar right up to the top. But Honeycrisp won't cook down quite like Regent, McIntosh, Cortland, Spartan, Viking, and like this. So I guess probably the Regent is one of my favorite ones.
So this is the place where we can buy apples, also something else?
Oh, yes. You can go pick your own. We'll give you a bag, and you can go right out to the orchard, pick them. And we've got a cooler here where all the apples are in there and displayed that they can sample them and see them. And this would be interesting when you show it in Europe. We've also got cranberries from a friend of mine. They bring cranberries here, and I take apples there, and they sell apples for me, and I sell cranberries for them. And we have, yes, fresh apple juice, which we make here. We try to get in the varieties that would bring it up to a sweet juice, and something that's not only good but good for us. Big hospital says if you take an apple and eat the seeds and chew them up, it kills cancer cells in our bodies. My dad always did this, and I kind of frowned on it, but he lived to be 96 and he didn't die with cancer, so that might be some thing that might be of interest to people.
I know, apple has a lot of different components, very positive. I wrote about a cosmetic kind of product for women. They did the cream, some oils from the seeds exactly, and from the skin of the apple.
Okay.
And it's really, really healthy, and it's very like aging cream, you know.
Okay.
Probably it works, I don't know, but.
I'm certain my daughter would know about it more than I would.
Yeah.
That's a Regent apple. Mm-hmm. I used to call them my Reagan apple mm-hmm. when Reagan was in, but now they're a Regent. They're, mm-hmm. they're an apple that will keep and be good for us. They're especially loaded this year. These won't be picked for a week or two yet, and they'll get brighter red, more color, and then the sugar content keeps going up. The pick your own is started in here now.
Mm-hmm. Probably they're ready.
Maybe we should take and we take the camera and take a picture of you eating an apple. There we go. Is this your daughter? Oh, I got daughters about her age, okay. About her height.
How old is she?
Well, I guess. Well, I don't think you're just in your 20s.
She's 20?
Pardon?
She's 20? No.
20 years old, but uh-huh. they're in their, the youngest one is 30.
Okay.
I think about 34.
All right.
So you're only, you don't tell how old you are though.
Yeah, I'm around 34.
Around, you say? Women are very cagey about that. Men, they just say, well, I'm about 84. I just turned 84 this month.
Really? Yeah. You look very good.
Because you eat
apple. Because of the apple, right?
Well, that's true.
Yeah.
And when you're in 2012, and again this year, a lot of my neighbors froze out. Matter of fact, one of them over here completely went out of business. And I give the Lord Jesus Christ the credit and the praise and the thanks for it. Because he made it possible that these things didn't freeze. And my livelihood is in here. And so you...
Mm-hmm. What kind of church are you doing?
Well, you name it, I've been there. All the way from the Catholics to the Lutherans to the Baptists to the Methodists. I normally don't talk church, variety of churches, because Jesus Christ, he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one is going to get to heaven but by through him. He's the only one that we can get our sins forgiven, because it says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, we're caught. And the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ.
Okay.
And I don't know if you've had constant pain in your back, you would be quite happy, but because it's all did in the name of Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. Don't ever forget that.
Okay.
Forget me. But see, all power in heaven and earth has been given to him.
Okay.
And through him. Now, I don't suppose you've heard all this,
mm-hmm.
but...
what you said, but it's interesting.
Yeah, you got pretty blue eyes too.
Oh, thank you. Can I throw it out somewhere, or we?
Well, just throw it just as far as you can. Either way you want it. You can, if you can throw it far enough, you can get it in the cornfield over there.
Uh huh.
You see that 8-foot fence? Would you believe I got deer that'll jump that 8-foot fence?
No, really.
Okay. I raise 2 to 4 fawns in here every year.
Okay.
And but we put that, they took in over here. I had one orchard over here, and they ate it off 2 times. They planted it 3 times. The third time, which is a kind of a sad story, we were trying to get electric fence of it, and my son-in-law, my daughter and him had just got married. He got electrocuted and died right over here, mm-hmm. and trying to keep the deer out. And we now have an 8-foot fence. They still get in there, and they can jump over it. We have problems. It isn't that they eat apples. That's no problem. I just wouldn't have them leave.
Okay.
But they plant a little tree like this and they'll keep it ate off. We have that privilege to know Jesus Christ. And so I, matter of fact, I'm say that, to put that on there. I'm not going to take up a question.
So you not belong to any religious? Not belong to any religious now, are you?
Well, see, you're talking a church.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ should be preached in every church. Do they do it? Well, they've got the same Bible I have. See, what bothers me, I was chairman of the church. And in the whole 9 yards, and I hunted and fished the ministers with what I've told you. If they thought anything of me, why didn't they tell me?
Mm-hmm.
And finally, somebody thought enough of me to talk to me. And I finally received Christ, had my sins forgiven,
mm-hmm.
and put it like this, God loves you.
God loves me?
You bet he does.
Okay.
You bet he does.
Phenomenal.
Phenomenal,
yeah. Energy.
Yeah.
Right?
If this is like paradise, think what in the world is going to be in heaven.
Yes.
It says that heaven should be here on earth.
Right, and it is. For me, it's a heaven. Hi, Poppy.
This is Gracie.
Hi, Gracie.
She'll come to girls first because my granddaughter that's in Hanover, Germany, that's her dog.
Okay.
And so she'll come right away quick to her.
This one looks beautiful.
Yeah, it's just amazing. It's an ordinary. You see the box inside?
Yeah.
Here, are you a ball player?
And the left hand. It's too much, but it's, I'm gonna
take a bite of that one now. See how that
comes
up with the one that you get out of the store.
Mmm.
Look at them beautiful blue eyes.
Mm-hmm. That's amazing.
Yeah, that's Johnny Appleseed. His name was McIntyre. And he was the one that grew apples, and he sold them or gave them to the people that were coming west.
Mm-hmm.
And he grew apples, and the McIntosh apple was named after him, McIntyre McIntosh.
Mm-hmm.
But he did one other thing. He preached Jesus Christ.
Okay.
You won't find that in your history book. They took that all out. We're in a socialistic government, we're going, and we're this country is being redone. Our forefathers were all believers that set that constitution up. Well, the greatest thing is there are two commandments we have in the Bible. That's love your neighbor as yourself, and love God with all your heart, soul, mind. That's the two commandments. If everybody did that, you won't have to have any other laws. We are open 7 days a week from 9 to 5.
Mm-hmm.
And as far as the apple trees, there's something that we work at that in the wintertime. We trim them. We take a lot of brush out of them. You're dealing with a light collector. And I think they think it take an apple and all that sweetness has to go down that little stem. And the wonders of God's creation of an apple down that stem and get the sweetness in there and then grow seeds. I've got trees planted out here that were growing up from seeds. And I know half of the population, one half is Honeycrisp, and the other half is, I don't know just what the other half is, but I got about a couple hundred trees that are all different varieties, trying to find that perfect variety. We grow cabbage.
Okay.
Cabbage and broccoli. I found out cabbage is as good as broccoli. A big hospital says, matter of fact, cabbage has got certain things in it that broccoli does not have. So cabbage is good for us to eat that. Sauerkraut, that is one of the things that are up on top of the list as far as cleaning our bodies out and for health and strength.
Lots of vitamin C I see here around.
Yes, and there's quite a few other things. Being a grower, I should know all this, but I got a daughter that's in that end of it. She could probably better tell you what all is there too, but yeah. Well, the location here, of course, you take I-94 and it splits at Toma and go up to 135. Exit, that's the Jellystone exit, and take that and go towards Warren's on EW. And I'm the first right-hand road off of EW is Cortland, right after the Cortland apple tree. That's the Cortland Avenue, and you take that right on that, and that'll bring you right up on top of a hill, and that's where you see trees, apple trees, here, there, and everywhere.